So, Yummy Noob recently did a video about all the most overrated motorcycles ever, and the Z900 from Kawasaki was first on the list. I really like the Z900 from my experience with it, and to be honest with you, I don't think I could go as far as to say that it's an overrated motorcycle. Maybe not as good as the M209, but pretty damn good. Today, we're on the Kawasaki Z H2, and I thought to myself, well, if there are people out there that think the Z900 is an overrated motorcycle, what about this one? Well, let's jump on and let's find out. I think some of you are going to know the answer to this one already, but let's do it. Yeah, and today I actually find myself somehow on a quiet day here at the Cheltenham Racecourse. Do you know, I've only been here a handful of times. I really should come here more often. There's plenty of places to shoot intros for videos. It's really nice as well. You've got like all the hills in the background, especially because it's nice and dusky right now. Let's see if I can show you guys some of the views from up here. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. Lovely views. Yeah, such a nice area this. Cheltenham is a nice place in general, but the race course, when it's not super busy, it's definitely worth a visit, at least just for the landscapes. But yeah, everybody, the ZH2, is it? No, you didn't see me? Okay, yeah, they didn't see me. They didn't look where they were going, despite how loud this bloody bike is. Anyway, let's not get bogged down with stupid drivers. But yeah, ZH2, is it an overhyped or overrated motorcycle? Well, I think a lot of this will depend on whether or not you like nakeds. Recently, we did a tier list video of all the different types of motorcycles that are worst and all the ones that are the best. And I ranked nakeds quite high up on the list. But definitely go and check out that video if you haven't done so already. I really enjoyed making that one, and you know, I think it turned out really well. So definitely check it out if you have time after this one. So if you're not into nakeds because, I don't know, there's not a lot of wind deflection or, I don't know, some other kind of excuse, then you are probably going to think that this is an overrated, overhyped motorcycle, regardless of what I say today. And I do want you guys to keep an open mind. You lot who really dislike nakeds for whatever reason, I would like you to keep an open mind. So the reason why I don't think this is an overrated motorcycle, or an overhyped motorcycle, shall we say, is because in a lot of ways this bike does break the mold. It is not a normal motorcycle. And when Kawasaki were designing this and building and engineering this bike, I think they were seriously looking outside the box. The styling, the colouring, yes, it still has the green accents of the Kawasaki brand colour, but this looks totally different to any other Kawasaki motorcycle, even among the Z series of bikes from them. And I really love the look of this bike. A lot of nakeds, you can make the argument that they're ugly. This, I don't have the heart to say that. This is such a nice bike in so many different ways, and the way how it performs, it's just on another level, and it just adds so much to the charm of this motorcycle. And when this bike was new, costing anywhere from 17,000 to 18,000, 20,000 pounds on the road, then yeah, you could have made a pretty good argument this bike was overrated, especially when you consider that you could get an MT-09, which is, again, or a Z900, which both are fantastic motorcycles in their own right, and significantly cheaper than the ZH2. So I haven't ridden around Cheltenham in a little while, so I'm trying to remember my whereabouts. I'm going left, right, left, right. I got a rough idea where I am. I'm not too worried. I like getting lost and finding my way back. But yeah, you could have made that argument. But now you can buy the ZH2 for as little as 10 grand, depending on the miles. But one from 2020, a first run production run ZH2, you could get one of these bikes for between 10,000-12,000 pounds, which is a little bit annoying for me because I'd hope that these bikes actually retain their value a little bit better than that, considering I'm still paying bloody finance on it. I've got a year left, and when I come to sell it, I'm only gonna get what, 10 grand for it? Oh dear. Yeah, not great. Not a great return on my investment. But regardless, for you guys who are looking to buy something like this from new, you're gonna have one killer deal. Seriously. Okay, so I can't take a right turn here. Why not? This isn't the one-way system. Ugh. Okay, that is the one-way system. Oh, I hate the one-way system. Once you get in it, you can't get out. Let's have a look. Let's see if I can find my way around here. Town centre east. No, that's not what I want. I want town centre west, I think. So yeah, right now you're getting a super unique motorcycle. I'm trying not to say just because of the supercharger, but the supercharger is quite a special thing, you know. There aren't that many bikes out there that have forced induction, and because these bikes are still new, even the used ones, they're still pretty damn new, it's like, it's a no-brainer. There's still plenty of life left in them. Yeah, all round fantastic motorcycles, very comfortable. I'll be definitely going to check out our review of this motorcycle. I'm thinking of doing a ride review of this bike instead. I don't know, I think that might be, because that's the more kind of modern thing that we're doing now, rather than doing studio versions of the ride reviews, actually taking them out and commentating on the experience as I ride it. Maybe we'll do that in the near future, I don't know, we'll see. But you guys let me know if that's what you'd like to see, a ride review of the ZH2 rather than our original review. But yeah, this bike is unique in so many ways because it has a load of horsepower that really can bite your head off if you're not careful. It has buckets of torque. This, for me, I think has got more torque than my ZR 1400, which is crazy because that bike is, on paper, got a lot more torque than this. But I think because of the design of the bike, the way how you're sitting quite upright, not tall, you're sitting upright, that you are feeling more of the torque. So it feels more torquey, if you know what I mean. The ZR doesn't quite feel as torquey as this, which is why I think this is like a tier above in terms of difficulty riding a bike like this. I think it is a tier above bikes like that, ZR 1400, which might sound crazy to say, but from my experience at least, that's one of the reasons why I absolutely love riding this bike, because of that torque. But okay, so reasons why, let's list out the reasons why this ZH2 here isn't overrated or overhyped. One is a supercharger. Two is the riding experience. Being able to combine force induction with such a positive riding experience. Like, for example, they could take out the supercharger out of this bike and it would still be a fantastic riding experience. No, it's not going to be producing 200 horsepower at the crank. It should be producing a similar amount of torque, but it might be producing somewhere like 150 horsepower instead if you deleted the supercharger for some reason. But It's a really good riding experience, regardless. Ooh, where the hell do I want to go? I think I want to go this way. Oh god, I can't go that way. Oh, bloody hell. Cheltenham! What are you doing to me? Yeah, so supercharger, force induction, riding experience, the tech package, despite the fact that it's getting on a bit now, this is still the standard. It's really top level stuff on this bike. And even though the H2 SX has got even better tech than this bike does, this is still pretty kitted out. So honestly, like, don't worry about the tech stuff. It's really good, still ultra modern. The looks of the bike are still incredibly modern as well, in my opinion. I think these looks are ahead of their time, which is why some people might not appreciate them, but I mean, that's just That's just my personal opinion. I mean, that is subjective at the end of the day, isn't it? What you like the look of and what you don't like the look of. But yeah, and the fact that you can change this display as well, this is the second display on this bike. You've got the original one as well. You can go from black to white. Right now I'm running the white because I think it's better, but well, I say better, I just wanted something different, you know. Reasons why this bike is overhyped or overrated. So I think one of the biggest arguments is that why don't you just buy a 1000SX? Why don't you just buy an MT10 instead? Why don't you just buy an MT09? Or why don't you just buy a Z900? There are so many motorcycles that can compete on an experience level with this bike that it's almost like you've really got to want that supercharger to buy this bike. It's almost like as if that's the only thing that really separates it from a lot of strong competition. But I actually think it does stand out from the competition, not just because of the supercharger, but because of all the other things that I've mentioned. I think this is the best naked riding experience that you can have at the moment. Oh goodness, I think I'm going back the way I came at this rate. Yeah, Bishop's Cleeve. Oh well. Cleeve Hill. Yeah, I've been down here before, but God, I can't remember which way I need to go. Oh no, it's not this way. I think I've gone the wrong way. I think I've taken a wrong turn. Oh well. This is the way we are going. What was I saying? Yeah, a lot of it is gonna depend on your tastes, what kind of motorcycles you like to ride. If you enjoy riding super sports, then this might not scratch that itch. Yes, it will give you adrenaline rush. It will, honestly, man, I think anybody that rides a ZH2 is gonna be so ecstatic about the riding experience. There aren't many bikes that can deliver this kind of riding experience, including super sports. Because you're getting so much torque lower down in the rev range, you're able to use the power, or a lot of it at least, for street use. Whereas modern supersports, nah, not really. You can't even get to the power band before you're breaking every single speed limit, at least here in the UK anyway. So for me, these kinds of bikes make a more compelling argument. But it's just, I don't know, guys, it's one of those things where I keep encouraging anybody to have a go on one of these motorcycles. If you've never been on naked before, try it. Honestly, they are at least worth a try. And if after you've had a go on one and you don't like it, well, okay, fair enough. But until that point, don't talk smack about nakeds until you've actually had a go on riding them. Like recently we had a comment about, well, basically the comment went like this: take a sports aura and you make it worse by taking away all the fairing and it makes the wind significantly worse. Just get a sports aura instead, or something to that effect. Okay, I'm gonna say why I disagree with that statement. So some of you may be worried about the whole wind thing on the bike. You got nothing here to protect you from the wind. To be honest with you, I don't feel any more wind on this bike than I do on any other motorcycle that I've ridden. Especially if you're going at these kinds of speeds, or even motorway speeds, I really don't think they're a big deal. But if that is something that worries you, I don't think it's too bad. In my humble opinion, from my experience, I don't think it's too bad. But again, try it out for yourself, and know for yourself, you know. If you need to prove it to yourself, then go ahead and test ride one. I'm sure that there are going to be some nakeds out there that provide better wind resistance than others. But the shape of the ZH2, I think, actually does quite a lot, despite the fact that you haven't got any kind of windshield that would, I don't know, traditionally deflect the wind. But the shape that it has I think does a pretty good job. And obviously you can get aftermarket windshields as well for the ZH2 that give you a little bit more wind resistance, but it's honestly, guys, I think when people talk about wind, I think they overblow it, how much of an impact it has on the riding experience. Seriously, that's not something I care about when I jump on this bike or any other naked that I've had to go on, for that matter. Same with sport tourers as well. You get a sport tourer, like a 1000SX, has a windshield, it's a sport touring machine, so rides a little bit like a naked. I don't get any less wind from that bike. I mean, what would be interesting would be to compare the sound levels between me riding this bike and me riding the H2SX or the 1000SX to see if it actually makes any difference whatsoever. I really don't think it does. So yeah, don't worry about it, guys, honestly, it's not worth your time. Yeah, we're back at the race course again. Well, that was a nice little detour, wasn't it? Right, let's see if I can figure out my way back. Oh, I'll tell you what, actually, let's go this way. Yeah, we get to see the pump room. Nice day to come out and ride today, considering it's late October and we've had plenty of rain going around. It hasn't been that cold, but it has been very rainy, so it's been, yeah, a little bit tedious trying to get out and ride, but let's pop down here. I think we'll be able to see the pump room from here. Some of you might be thinking, well, what's so special about a damn pump room? Well, I mean, there isn't anything really that special about it. It's just a nice building. We can find where it is. Haven't seen any signs this way. Bit of open room. There it is. It's just a nice building. It's just something nice to look at. There's lots of nice architecture in Cheltenham. It's quite a modest place, but it is a nice place to be. Yeah, very pretty building. Believe it or not, I don't think I've ever been in there. And Pitbull Park as well. What a good idea, I'll show you. It's a lovely park. Yeah, gorgeous. And there's a little lake down there as well. Lovely. I'll tell you what, let's go this way. Can I get out here? Can I get here? No, can't get out here. Let's go around the car park. Usually I can get in and out. Oh, I'll tell you what, actually, there's a little gate there. As long as there's no pedestrians. No, we're good. Ha ha! Yeah! Woo! Yeah, nice little adventure there, isn't it? A little bit of a detour. Alright, everybody, so after all that, well, I still ride the ZH2, I still think it's one of the best motorcycles in the world, and even when my finance is up on the bike, when I finish paying it off, I'm still going to keep it. I really do think it's that good, despite the fact that there are bikes out there that I would also like to have at some point in the near future. I don't think I can let go of this bike, not yet anyway. There isn't anything that quite scratches this itch with the ZH2. Yeah, seriously, it's a really good bike. Riding experience, I mean, this is peak motorcycle riding experiences. Such a lot of fun, man. And that's what we're after, right? We ride a motorcycle because of the fun factor. Well, if you want maximum fun, this is one of the bikes that does give you maximum fun. So, any motorcycle that is fun, in my opinion, I don't think you can say it's overrated. If it is a lot of fun, which this bike is. All right. And that's really it. On that Yami Nu video that we mentioned right at the beginning, How can a motorcycle be overrated if loads of people enjoy buying them? Loads of people enjoy riding them. Loads of people talk really positively about them. You know. I really don't think there is such thing as an overrated motorcycle. I think it's just what you like to ride. What you like the look of and what you like to ride. That's what it comes down to at the end of the day. This is the bike for me. So, and I think I'm going to continue riding naked well into the end of this decade. And, well, I think I'm going to continue riding naked full stop. They're that good. At least every naked that I've been on so far haven't been disappointing at all. Even the ones that have got less power, less torque, they're still incredibly fun to ride. And I think that's what it comes down to, everybody. So, and I know my way back from here now, so I'm gonna enjoy the rest of this ride out today, make the most of it before the sun sets. But thank you ever so much for joining us on today's ride on the awesome Kawasaki Z H2. If you were looking at buying one, now is probably the time to do it. This camera has just died. I'm sure that one's about to as well. So let's end the video quick. As always, go ahead, leave that like, hit that subscribe button and that notification bell if you enjoyed this video, you found it informative. Definitely let me know what you think about the ZH2 and which other motorcycles you think are on the same level playing field as this bike, because there's a lot of competition. So if there's a motorcycle that I think is the best right now, it's probably this. But yeah, everybody, thanks again. Take care. Ride safe. We'll catch you all in the next video. Have a good one.